You stand condemned because you've done wrong before Almighty God. There is nobody on earth that can stand before the law of God and say that I am innocent, because we all are guilty. There is nobody innocent before God. Everybody is guilty. It doesn't matter who you are or where you come from. When we look to God, we are guilty, and we are guilty, and we can do nothing about it. It's not nothing about your good deeds, nor your religious acts. There's nothing that you can do on your own merit that can make you not guilty before God. The Bible says that all have sinned. The Bible says that let God be true and every man a liar. That if we look to the law of God, we look to his righteous law, we look to his standards, and that we fall short every time. If anybody says that they're innocent before God, they are a liar. The Bible says that the wages of our sin is death. And that we have to die one day if you don't let Jesus forgive you of your sin. That you'll pay the price for your own sin. That one day you'll stand before God in judgment, and then you'll pay your own price for sin. You'll pay your own price for your sinful life. For the lies, for the fornication, for the stealing, for the blasphemy, for the idolatry, all this, you'll pay the price one day. You may ignore it, you may not believe it. You will pay the price one day. But we're telling you to tell everybody today that you don't have to pay the price, because Jesus Christ paid that price. Jesus Christ came down as a man to live a life perfect and holy, to show us how to live. They lived a perfect and holy life. And that they only lived for us, that he died and took our place on the cross. It was the perfect sacrifice. Then not only did Jesus die, but on the third day he rose again. Jesus rose to life on the third day. And because of this we can have forgiveness today. We can have forgiveness in Jesus. There's no religion that can forgive your sin. There's no priest, there's no man, there's no nothing, but only Jesus Christ that can forgive our sin today. And the truth of the matter is this, that we need Jesus. We need Jesus. Everybody thinks that we need money, we need wealth, we need power, we need this and that. But without Jesus, how are we going to stand on judgment day? Without Jesus, what are we going to have that day when we stand before God? Without Jesus, we have nothing. Everything in this world will perish and pass away. Everything that you have or aim or want to get will all pass away. But Jesus Christ is alive, and he's alive forevermore. Jesus lives and reigns forever. And one day he's going to come back. One day he's going to come back. And whether you're ready or not, Jesus is coming back. Whether you believe it or not, Jesus is coming back. And how do we stand before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? How do we stand before Jesus Christ? Do we stand in our sin? Do we stand condemned, or do we stand forgiven? On that day of judgment, are we going to be condemned, or are we going to be forgiven? Because either you have Jesus or you don't. Either you're condemned or you're not. But there's hope, there's forgiveness, mercy and grace in Jesus Christ. There's forgiveness, there's love, there's grace and mercy in Jesus. There's no one else that we can be saved, only by Jesus Christ. We have a choice today. What are we going to make? What choice are we going to make? Are we going to live our lives for ourselves? take the chance, knowing that one day we're going to die, or we're going to put our hope and our faith and our trust in Jesus, to one who died and one who rose again. Folks, we can't get away from the fact that the man Jesus of Nazareth, he died and rose again. You can check that biblically, you can check that historically, whatever way you want to check that, the man Jesus Christ died and he rose again. There, over 500 people saw him alive after he had risen. And then Jesus died and rose again, and he did it because he loves you.